Again, we speak about some of the standard norms, and you heard a lot of my panelists talk of the various norms and the procedures that are put into place. Yes, that is a requirement, and believe you me, a lot of companies in India are among the global best in complying with those norms, in putting them into place. But the desire to say that we will wish away criminal intent, the desire to say that it will not happen, is utopian. It will never happen in that basis. Unfortunately, and I really do believe it is unfortunate, our press does play a role in sensationalizing the events that do happen. Let me take a particular case. It got front pages of our mainline dailies, front pages, top headline banner news, which is now lovingly called the Karan Bari case. There was allegation that this person working for a BPO industry stole data and sold it for X million dollars. The allegation was for data from UK companies. And the headline said BPO industry embroiled in fraud and BPO employee does fraud. Karan Bari did not work for a BPO company. Reality, he did not. And I spoke to the journalist and I said, but he doesn't work for a BPO company, he works in an IT company. Said, oh, is it? Okay. They checked and they came back and said, 4 years ago, you know, he worked for a BPO company. Ah, okay. So I said, how was the meeting of the RBI governor with President Musharraf? Said, RBI governor did not meet President Musharraf. Said, Prime Minister Manmohan Singh used to be the RBI governor. What happened? His company did not deal with UK customers. The company he used to work 4 years ago with did not have those companies that were alleged, the data of whose was alleged to have been given as customers. Oh, okay, another small fact we forgot. Oh, okay. The UK company's names were given in that report by the Sun newspaper. Those UK companies gave press releases that they do not outsource to India. Oops. So where did he get the data if that data didn't come to India? It was not even reported by the newspaper that these companies do not outsource data to India. In fact, one company gave a statement, forget outsourcing to India, they don't outsource. All their work is done in the UK itself. But we made such a big deal out of it because there was an element of sensationalization. I am not sitting here and telling you that fraud does not happen. It happens, it's real. We need to find a way to tackle it. We have a good enough system. If you look at what happened in Pune, our police reacted on the report. The people who were alleged to have done the crime were caught, they were put in jail. There was adequate law to take action against them and action was taken. Now again, I'm not saying that the law cannot be improved, the process cannot be made better, it can be. The question each one of us for our companies need to look at is, how do we create a continuous improving environment? How do we share information? One last point I wanted to make to you. Many, many years ago, I dismissed 21 employees for alleged fraud. Not in Quattro, but in one of my previous organizations. And in that discussion we had with the employees, we said, either you resign or we will sack you. And one employee, the senior most, came back and said, I want 24 hours to think about it. And he was back in about 17 hours, showing me his thumb, saying, I already have another job. Nobody checked. As NASSCOM, we've now put in a database where the top companies of the industry are sharing data with each other. Because complying with the BS 7799 or some of the requirements to say do a police check, you can go and do a police check at a police station outside, but this police station only knows about fraud that was committed in its area. Our police stations are not connected. It is not a single database. So it is not the tick the box that is required. If we have to overcome it, what we need as an industry is cooperation. We need to be able to fight it together to see that the criminal business, those five people's companies, go out of business. One company cannot do it. We have to do it as an industry. Thank you very much.